So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create your own online design portfolio using the online website creation platform, Wix. And I'm using Wix in this video because it's a really powerful platform to use, and it's actually incredibly customizable when it comes to positioning things on your website and making changes, but we'll dive into that in a bit. And as far as design portfolios go, whether you're looking for a job, you're looking for some freelance work, or you just want a place online to showcase what you do, it's really important that you do that in a place that gives you a lot of flexibility and also gives you a lot of customization options. So the portfolio that you create really speaks to you and your design or creative sensibilities. So that's a big reason of why I'm using Wix, is because it absolutely lets you do that. And I'm also showcasing this today because Wix was kind enough to sponsor this particular video. So in the description of this video, I will add a link to Wix that you can click and then go to Wix and get started creating your own online portfolio or website. So if you want to just go to that link, check it out, and then go along with this video, feel free to do so. I'll do my best to show you the basics of how to go in here and start creating some awesome websites. So the very first thing Wix is going to ask you is, what kind of website do you want to create? And all these various options will essentially show you templates that are really appropriate for the reflective thing that they might be, whether it's business, online store, photography, or in our case, designer, or even portfolio and CV. And while I'll be working on a portfolio in this video, what I'm showing you will be applicable to any one of these things. Any template you pick, the editor works just the same. So feel free to do whatever is appropriate for you. I'm gonna jump to designer because that's what we'll be working on today. And it's gonna ask you if you wanna let Wix ADI create a website for you, or if you wanna create your own using the Wix editor. The ADI is basically a series of questions that you can answer, and then it will automatically build up a website for you that's appropriate based on those questions. But because I wanna show the full functionality and power of the Wix editor, we're gonna choose a template for that. And there are actually a ton of different templates that you can go in here and check out. There's 5 pages for just design alone. And if you want to check out templates for other things, you can go to the left-hand side menu and click on some of these and see the appropriate templates for them. So just run through here and find templates that you think look interesting. As you highlight over them, you can either go to edit to start creating your own website right away, or you can also just click on view, which will open them up so that you can see how these look and also how they interact as you go through here and test stuff out. If you do find a template that you like, you can go ahead and edit it. This automatic pop-up came up to let us know we can do that. Also, there's an edit this site button in the upper right-hand corner that you can click at any time. And on the left-hand side, you can also switch to mobile by clicking the mobile icon if you wanna see how this will look in a mobile device. So really easy to flip between that and desktop as you're trying to figure out which one of these templates works best for you. As I mentioned before, there's 5 pages just for design. So spend some time up front and make sure that you pick a template that you really like. While you can go in here and totally customize these to be 100% different, if the starting point is at least close to what you're looking for, that'll save you a bunch of time. So might as well get going from a starting point that feels pretty good to you. And since I already picked a template before, I actually picked the one on the second page, which is this one right here. I'm just gonna go to my dashboard and then I'm going to move to edit site so we can check this out and learn the basics of how to go in here and customize stuff. It's actually super fast and easy to do that. And essentially there's 2 main things you can do to edit stuff from the get-go. If you click on any element, whether it's this menu right here, whether it's this gallery of images, it'll bring up little submenus that you can then go in and customize. So when it comes to this gallery view of images, you can click on Manage Media, which will bring up every image that Wix has sort of pre-populated for you. And you can drag and drop these around to change the positioning of them on the site. It's easy to do that. And also, at least when I work with templates like this, I tend to want to actually just go in here and then replace the images rather than adding new ones, since all the work around linking these together to pages and all that stuff has been done. So in this case, this cool hand illustration, if I want to change this from what it is right now, and if you're building your own portfolio, I'm going to assume you want to change all these, you can just click on Replace Image, which will then bring up a menu right here where you can just drag and drop right into the screen with images that you want to replace this with. So I have a YouTube thumbnail. I'm just going to drag and drop right here, and then it's going to upload it to Wix. And once this processes, we should be able to go ahead and just switch that out. So right here, you can see that has been added, and then I'll just click Add to Page, which should go ahead and add that. So right here, we have that. I'm going to drag it off to the front. And also with these images, if you want to change the title, I don't think you'd want this to be offset type tutorial.png. You can just click that and I could write something like Illustrator tutorial. And then it goes ahead and changes that in real time. And also you can change a link from here. So you can also pick what page this links off to from all the different pages that are currently in your site. So all that is totally able to be done right from that gallery. Really easy to do. So I'm going to hit done. And also, and that's my image right here, it showed up. If I go to the settings when I click gallery, that also gives some additional options. You can either manage the media, which is what we just did. But the cool thing with galleries is you can pick from a bunch of different potential layout options, whether it's a collage to large thumbnails that have images or little thumbnails below that, and also large sliders or even slideshows. So you can go in here and customize this however you see fit. And I'd say just play around for a bit, see which one looks the best for how you want to present your images. And then the design options, which might be pretty appropriate as you're trying to customize this. For example, if I were to preview this and hover over any of these images, there'd be a pink overlay. So if I want to change that, and this is showing that on my screen right now, you can just click on design and then overlay and icons. And from there, you can just click on that color and make it whatever color you want. You can also click the plus sign in My Colors, and there's a color picker that's very similar to what you'd see in Illustrator or Photoshop, where you can pick any color you could ever imagine, or even change it by hex, RGB, or HSB codes. So if that's something you want to do, feel free to do that. And I can also go in here and change text. You can change the alignment of the text, whether it's on the left side, have it be centered, or on the right side. I actually like center. You can change the vertical alignment by going to the top, the middle, or the bottom. I like the middle. So just go in here, play around with the settings until it looks a way that you want. If I want to make this text on hover white instead of black, I actually prefer that. Super fast, and it updates in real time right in front of you, so it's very easy to see the impact of your choices. If you don't like what you did, you can always go back and just do it a different way. So I'm going to keep moving along here so we can show you the left-hand side menu, which is perhaps the most powerful part. So the top one is the site menu, which functions really similar to a sitemap. So you can see work, which is all these individual pages for each one of these thumbnails. And if you click on that, it'll actually bring you to that page where you can check that out. And also you can go in here and edit right from this page. So a really fast and easy way to navigate. There's a store page on this particular theme. So you can see that's right there. And also an info page. And let's say you pick this particular theme and you don't want to have a store. If you select that and then go to the three dot menu and click it, you can actually just go to hide, which will hide this from the site and will also remove it from that top navigation menu. So I did that, and now this from the top menu is gone. There's no more store in the middle. So I'd actually recommend just disabling visibility if you don't want people to see that, in case you do want to go in and update to add a store later on. But alternatively, you could duplicate this and make multiple stores or multiple store pages, or even just delete it and have it be gone from your website for good if you know this isn't something that you're ever going to want to use. And that also applies to each individual work page. If you want to take advantage of the template and not recreate these from scratch, you can just duplicate one of these work pages and make all the changes you need to there, and then go ahead and just add another image to the gallery that we checked out before, link to that new work page, and you're good to go. It's all pretty intuitive and easy to do once you get used to doing it. Also in the side menu, you can change the page background. So whether it's a video, an image, or a color, these ones up at the top here, for example, are videos. I don't personally tend to put full page videos or images behind my website, but this is totally here and easy to do if that's something you want to do. Also, if you want to ever, like if you add an image or a video like this and you don't want that anymore, just go to color. You can pick any color you want. And even as I go in here and do this, it updates all this in real time so you can see how this impacts or affects every single page on your site. So pick whatever color you want. Like I mentioned before, you can also add custom colors and My Colors, and it will remember other colors that you've done previously, like this blue that I added in. So go around and play in here and just do whatever you want to do, whatever works best for you. It's easy to switch it back if you don't like it. Past that, this is probably my favorite part of the entire Wix editor. The plus icon or the add icon in this left-hand menu lets you add essentially whatever you want, wherever you want to this entire site. So for text, there's theme text. And theme text also just means like for your appropriate theme that you're working with right here. But there's also things like titles. So if I want to add this huge title, you just click and then you hold and then you drag it over right onto your site. And then it's part of your site. Wherever you place it is exactly how it's going to look and exactly how it's going to show up. If you click edit text while that's selected, it'll let you go ahead and increase the font size. If that's something you want to do, if you want to make this an actually really huge title, you can change the font, you can change the alignment, pretty much anything you want to do. It's all fair game within the Wix editor. And if I want to just make this longer, I can go ahead and do that. If you double click on the type, just like you would in most editing programs, you can change that. So I could write taco type, and there you go. It's very easy to customize, and truly wherever you want this to go, and this is something that's very different about Wix, is exactly how this is going to show up. So I'm just going to bring these images back up here so they kind of overlap this huge type, and I'm just trying to center that. And now you can see this type is actually overlapping or on top of that image. And if I were to go to preview in the upper right-hand corner of this top menu, just to check how this site looks as if it were live, you can see it looks exactly as you would expect. It's pretty amazing how flexible this is in terms of positioning. It doesn't force you to a grid or force you to a particular style of work. It's kind of wherever you want to put stuff, it'll let you do, and it'll make it look great on the actual live site. I'm going to actually just, whoops, click back to editor instead of closing this accidentally, and go back to the add menu. So there's a ton of options for type. These are all titles, but there's also paragraphs here. So if you want to add paragraph type, you're totally free to do so. It works just the same as anything else. Just click this in the menu and then hold and drag it over to the side here. And if you end up adding something that you don't want, you can just click it and then hit your delete button or backspace button, and it will go ahead and remove that from the site. And also what's interesting too is if there is type already on here and you know that's formatted in a way that you want, you can just hit Control C or Command C on a Mac and then Control V or Command V, and that'll just copy and paste it. And that was just for the text, but you can also add images, including free Wix images or other stock images. There's also a gallery. So if you want to add image galleries to any page you want, they're here. There's vector art, including some really cool vector art if you want to have a really fun page. If you're doing your own design or illustration portfolio, you might want to stick to your own work, but there is also really good illustration work. This is an awesome tiger illustration built into Wix, and you can just move these, you can resize them. It's pretty cool how flexible this is. And even when you do weird stuff like this, where I would never purposely design a website where everything's overlapping like this, but if I preview this, you can see that it functions perfectly, and even the type that's overlapped by or hidden by this tiger, still totally selectable. It'll be searchable on Google just like any other text on the page would. So I've never seen a website editor work like this, and it's kind of cool to see just how flexible it is. But we're going to keep checking some other stuff out. There's also things like shapes. So these shapes are here if you want to do some visual elements or even add call out boxes. If I bring this blue one and put that on here, you can also click when that's selected, it'll look kind of like a paintbrush to go to design. And then you can change the color to something else. If you want to have this be a different color, looks like a text box or a comment box, you can make the opacity lower. Just go in here and play around with it and see what makes sense for you. It's super easy. And I just deleted that by clicking delete. So anything you don't want, you can very easily remove it, no problem. But feel free to check out everything that's available in here. There is a ton of stuff, and it all functions the exact same. You just click, hold, and drag it onto the page. You're good to go from there. There's really too much to show in this video, but even music players are built right in with Wix Music or SoundCloud players or Spotify players. So kind of regardless of what you're trying to showcase here, whether it's music, art, video, this can handle it all, and I think that's pretty cool. So that's pretty much it for what I'm going to really show you on the sidebar. You can also build blogs or even do online bookings if you have a restaurant, for example, where that's something that's valuable to you. But I want to talk a bit about the structure of an online portfolio to make it as effective as possible. So I'm actually going to remove this taco type because it's distracting to me. But when you're showing your work, I think what's really important here is that you don't just show your work. Hopefully you're also explaining why that work was made and what the outcomes were. And I say that specifically if you're trying to, for example, get a design job or find some freelance, it's really helpful to talk about what was the problem you were trying to solve, And of course, show all the images to back this up. That's very important, or whatever your work happens to be. But talk about, why was this work made? How did you approach that problem that you were presented? Whether it was someone trying to get people to click on a banner image, or to drive traffic to a website, or even just to communicate a message effectively. Explaining that problem, how you worked to solve that problem, and then what the outcome was as far as how did your work help that business or help that person that you were freelancing for. Or even if you were doing this totally for yourself, just talking through why you were pushing yourself to make it, it can communicate a lot to the people who check out your website so they can better understand who you are as a creative. And I do think that is really important. And I'm just going to go back to the main work page here so we can check this out. So with every section, if you click on it, you can go ahead and edit the design by just clicking that paint icon. So for example, right now, there's these horizontal menus where you can change these to look totally different by just, if you hover over them, you can see how it looks in real time. You can also customize the design right here by changing things like fill, color, and opacity. If I go here, there's a background that I can go ahead and change, messing around with corners or shadows or even text. So if I want the text to be not black as a standard color, I can change it to like a purple. So feel free to play around with this. Like I said, if you hover over anything, you'll probably see a menu pop up as soon as you click it. And it's really that easy to go in here and get going. But that is it for this video. I do want to say another thank you to Wix for sponsoring this. This is a really cool platform that's super customizable and flexible for your design needs as you go in here and make your own online portfolio. And once again, there is a link in the description of this video. Just click that if you want to check out Wix. Also, by doing that, you're helping support this channel, so I appreciate it. But past that, if this video was helpful, please consider subscribing. I do my best to keep creating new content just like this. And also hit the thumbs up button to like the video and let me know that you liked it. And of course, if you have questions or comments, whether it's about this or anything else, feel free to leave those in the comments section. Either I or someone else can help you or respond to whatever you're thinking. But that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching.